East San Jose. It is coming. It's right around the corner. With me today are Ryan Nyquist, who's a gold medalist in BMXing, and also with us is Stephen Lanzock, who is a soon-to-be gold medalist. Is that right?
Yep. Next in line.
There you go. We have some video. This is a San Diego event with some BMXing going on there. And what's this like for you, Ryan? Look at that.
Yeah, that's actually like on a racetrack, which is a sort of a different aspect, but very cool. You know, like that's a lot of stuff we do is, you know, riding on the dirt, and it just kind of brings it back to the roots. You know, like a lot of kids grew up with bicycles and jumping off curbs, and that's kind of like the next step, and that's how a lot of these guys got into it. I'm sure it was Steve the same way, like started out jumping small, and then, you know, that's some actually really big jumps right there, but you know, like that's kind of how you progress, and that's how I got to where I was. Is just, you know, like going around the neighborhoods and kicking out, and you know, jumping off the curbs and making your own little jumps out of plywood, and then you know, you elevate and you find these places to go, and that's kind of what we're doing with our event, Warriors of Wood, is just trying to find a place for kids to go so they can, you know, progress their skills.
So if you're out in Willow Glen or up at Pacific Heights in San Francisco, you see some kid doing that, don't yell at him. He's all right. He's gonna be okay.
Yeah. I mean, we've all experienced a couple of yelling, but you know, it's all positive stuff. I mean, I'm sure you can see. He just had an event. Actually, he got fifth place, you know, this past weekend. So
what do you get out of it, Steven?
More just coverage, like people knowing who you are. Just you get to get out there and just show that the sport's something good and not nothing bad.
Yeah. They're bringing this whole event to San Jose PAL here in East San Jose, and that's coming. We'll show you all the information in just a second. Do you have any scars, any war scars, battle scars to prove?
Plenty of them.
But talk to the kids out there, though, if you will. The kids who are reluctant to wear the helmet, are reluctant to wear the pads. What can you tell them?
I mean, you wear a helmet, of course, it's safety. And BMXing is not easy. It takes time, practice. A lot of you fall, you just get back up, keep trying. And just never give up at it. I've been doing it for about 4 years, and I fall, broken plenty of bones, but you just get back up, keep going.
What is it? What's up here?
Well, I mean,
let's you do that.
It's just you know, it's a passion. You know, it's challenging yourself. It's going out there and seeing what you can do. But also, it's also a very big social aspect too. You know, a lot of your friends do it, and then, you know, it's a thing you do after school. You go to the skate park, you hang out and stuff, and that's always been such a great part, is just seeing kids, you know, doing something positive. They go to skate park and ride and use their energy into doing something progressive and to better themselves. And, you know, it's a fitness aspect. There's so many different things that make our sport great. And it's just, it's such a cool, like, experience to be out there and riding. And, I mean, if you've ever even ridden a bike down the street and, you know, like, gone off a curb or like that, you can know how hard this is, because you can go to a local skate park and see these kids jumping and stuff like that. And our event on Saturday is going to be, you know, the best of the best out there jumping off these massive, I mean, jumps like this size, you know, but all made out of wood, and it's all going to be at San Jose PAL Stadium, and it's such a cool thing, man, it really is, and I've spent the majority of my life doing it, and I have zero regrets.
we'll show that video again in just a sec, but talk to the kids as well, if you can, because, I mean, the safety aspect is important here, whether you're BMXing or not.
Yeah, I mean, like you said before, you got to wear a helmet, you know, like, you got to protect your brain, because if you hurt your brain, then that affects everything, so it's, you gotta protect that part. But you know, like for me, I wear elbow pads, knee pads, you know, like gloves, everything, and it just lets you do what you love to do longer. That's the way I look at it. It's a career extender, you know, these pads. So whether it's a, you know, a career move for you or something you like to do for fun, nobody likes to get hurt. You know, that's one of the worst things about a sport is injuries, but you know, it happens. You know, it happens in every sport, football, basketball, baseball,
right.
And it's just part of it, and you learn to accept it. But it's, you know, for me, it's like those times when I'm not able to ride my bike, it makes me want to ride that much more, you know, it's like, because you can't do it, it's like, oh, so yeah.
Is this a precursor to something, maybe motocross or something like that?
You know, a lot of guys do transfer over, but we've had a lot of guys go the other way too, from motocross to BMX.
Oh, really?
So it's all personal preference, and I know we have a big moto scene, and you know, here in the valley and all that stuff,
right.
and that's cool, and you know, we have also a BMX racing scene. There's a track at in Santa Clara. And there's, you know, ramp skate parks and, you know,
okay.
around the city and stuff. But, you know, a lot of those skate parks aren't really bike friendly. You know, and that's what we're trying to create. It's just a place for BMXers to go, you know, where it's a safe environment. And, you know, we're trying to create something at PAL where, I mean, you can't get much safer than at PAL. You got police officers everywhere. You know, it's good. So, and that's been one of the really odd things to me, is that partnership. Because, you know, in our past, you know, we've been kind of like the hoodlums and stuff. And
right.
now we're teaming up with the police and kind of trying to create this positive thing. And that's always been one of the coolest things about this whole project.
I always stayed away from you guys. Yeah. what's it like, Stephen, to have this come to especially the East San Jose, a big event like this, professional event?
It's nice because it kind of gives you a break from all the stuff at the skate park, people trying to maybe steal your bike or you know, just trying to hurt you just because you're on a bike. This gives you to come out, enjoy a good biking scene, have fun with your friends, and just watch some cool stuff happen.
Is this a career thing for you?
Yeah.
Kind of like Ryan,
yeah.
Really?
I'm trying hard.
And what's it like to sit next to a gold medalist?
Pretty good.
Real quickly, what does it take to be a gold medalist?
What he said before.
A few broken bones and some broken arms?
You know, that stuff, it can happen. You know, obviously, that's in the back of your mind. But really, it just takes work, commitment, you know, like dedication. And, you know, I say this to everybody, too. You got to have fun with it. You know, if it's not fun, then it's not for you.
Right.
You know, like, you can't force it. So it's, you got to have fun with it. And you know, he has a great time with it. You know, it seems that's very obvious. He, you know, he's got a big smile on his face when he's talking about it. And that's awesome. And that's... You know, it's just, you gotta enjoy it, but it is hard work, you know, it is.
I still have the training wheels on my bike.
We'll work on that. We'll get you at the event. We'll take the training wheels off for the first time.
There it is.